It is soup weather, friends. So we decided it would be fun to have a friendly soup cook-off this morning, and we want you to share yours with us, too. That makes sense?
Yes.
We share with you, you share with us.
Yep.
Go to our Care 11 Facebook page. You can post something right there.
There are a bunch already coming in. We're going to share some in just a few minutes. But Bobby is making his favorite tomato basil soup for us this morning.
Yep.
Bob, how do you do it?
It's really pretty simple. There's not a lot of ingredients. You take a small onion, chop it up fine, some celery, and you put that together with garlic. Now, it says to use one clove of garlic. I've never made a recipe with one clove of garlic.
I was gonna say,
I put three cloves of garlic.
That's good. I like garlic,
in.
So we're good. Yeah.
So
okay.
You add
as long
that,
as we're all eating it, it's fine.
And you saute it down. Then you add San Marzano, which is the best tomatoes you can get. You add San Marzano in there. It said diced, but I like these better. These are the peeled.
I can just see Phyllis holding her breath right now at your house.
All right, you add the basil. Yeah.
Oh, that's a lot of basil.
Yeah, I know. You add that, which would be the thyme. And then you can use either chicken stock or you can use vegetable. I took vegetable. And you add 2 cups.
Okay.
Which this is. And then you bring it to a boil, which is this one.
Yeah, our very expensive stove that we have.
So then you bring it to a boil, then you let it simmer for somewhere around 10 minutes, 10, 15 minutes afterwards. But once you bring it to a boil, which it'll happen.
In just a moment.
We use these.
Okay, oh so while we wait for
we
it
really
to get to
that?
A boil, should we talk about our soups?
Well, I think we should.
Yeah.
They look fabulous.
You go first.
You need to go first.
Okay.
That's
what we're going to do?
Okay. Yeah.
So mine is actually a recipe I got from Julie, and it is a red Thai curry soup with chicken. And mine is supposed to be more brothy, but I decided to add more chicken and more noodles because why not?
Yes.
And so I made it yesterday and it was brothy yesterday and now it's a little thicker, so it's kind of like a stew. So
I love that it has all this accoutrement.
Yeah, so a lot of stuff. So you go ahead and serve it, and then you if you love cilantro, go
yes.
for it. And a lot of people do and a lot of people don't.
Why? I don't understand where people say it tastes like soap.
Well, some people it does like to their, I don't understand it either. So I put some cilantro on mine.
Okay.
And then green onions.
Okay.
And so, there's some basil, the basil that didn't freeze outside my door. Okay. And then, yeah, the key is you have to squeeze a lime over it.
Okay, I'm stealing, I'm reaching.
Go.
Yep. Throw me a lime.
Okay, you can grab all this stuff, Bob. And
all
there's
right.
your spoon
thank
right
you.
There.
Thank you.
Do you have your spoon?
I do not have a spoon.
Okay, that's your spoon. That's my spoon.
Okay.
Anyway, so that's it. And it is really today. Oh, it has coconut milk, red pepper, red curry paste. It's not too spicy.
I'm all in.
Okay.
And you didn't scrimp on the chicken. There's nice,
I like
nice
to put a lot
chicken.
More chicken yeah. in. I put a lot more chicken in than normal.
All right.
Oh, gosh, that's
first
really good.
First taste test.
What, are these rice noodles?
Yes, pad Thai rice noodles.
That's really good.
Thank you. It's good. I like it a lot. I like
oh,
it.
Oh, the curry flavor is fabulous.
Yeah, that's really
very good.
Good.
I know it kind of has a lot of layers to it. There's a lot of ginger in it. So there it is. Okay, now what is this?
I'm gonna be honest. This isn't my favorite soup. I've never made it before, but I knew you were making chicken, and I knew he was going vegetarian, so I decided to go with. And Bobby, you're gonna have to help me with this. Is it pasta fazool?
Pasta fazool.
Pasta fazool.
Zool. Z-O-O-L at
the end. There you go. And according to this recipe, it said it was a knockoff of the Olive Garden's version. So I don't know.
the soup for days?
Yes.
Olive Garden,
exactly.
Okay.
So this one has some ground beef just in the pot. Mm-hmm. And then you take that out. And then you do the carrots and the celery and the onions. And then added the chicken stock. And then put the beef back in and boiled it up with all the herbs
kidney
in
beans
it.
And
so like basil, oregano, thyme. Marjoram, and I put a little nutmeg in because I love a little nutmeg in a winter soup. So it's a little smidge
it's
of nutmeg
really
in there.
It's really good.
Cook the pasta separately, which I find works better because if you don't, it soaks up all the water in the soup.
Yeah, that's kind of what happened here.
Yeah, so yeah. I cooked the pasta separately and then dumped it all in and then topped it off with some Parmesan cheese and some crusty bread.
Rena knows her way around the kitchen. I'm just going to say
that right now.
I'm usually a better baker than a cook, but so I've never actually had it before, so we'll see how it goes today.
It's really, really good. Yeah. I'm already kind of diving in. Okay, are we ready to...
What is that thing called? An immersing something or other?
Immersion
experience?
Yeah, yeah, so go for it.
Right.
So it's at almost a boil.
It's almost at a boil.
Okay.
And then you take it and you try not to get this all over yourself.
Okay.
And what it does is it grinds everything together and it gets thicker and thicker. Now, they did say if you want it thick, you can take cannellini beans,
mm-hmm.
add a couple of add a can of those in there.
Oh, yeah.
And that'll, yo, there you go.
Okay.
All right. So it's getting there now.
I like that.
And the thing is, it's 30 minutes. 15 minutes of prep and 15 minutes of cooking. So it's really, really a quick, easy way.
And it freezes well. Okay, here we go. A lot of people make tomato basil soup, but I love it.
Okay, garlic, tomato basil.
Oh yeah, lots of garlic. Oh, Bob, it's really good.
Yes.
Well, yeah, it's got a lot of nice flavor. As long as you use the 3 garlic cloves, I think, instead of 1. Really puts it over the top.
I like it. Yeah. That's very good.
I would put your Parmesan on top. And
ooh, we got extra parm up there.
Yeah.
We can certainly do that.
So speaking of great recipes, you guys had a chance to share some of yours with us, so we appreciate it. So let's go through a few and show you what we have. Oh, we've got a velvety vegetable cheese soup.
Yes.
That sounds really good.
Yeah.
I can't read who the person is, but it's
is that orzo or chicken?
It's a turkey noodle vegetable.
Oh, there you go.
Suzanne. Okay, that's awesome.
Your eyes are much better than mine. I can't see any of this.
And Linda. Linda brought a butternut squash soup with black beans. Oh, that's interesting.
All recipes.
I like that. That's a. Okay, we have another Linda with a Polish sausage soup. Well, that's a good idea.
I'm still eating yours, Belle.
And then we have Patricia, and she's got a hearty chicken noodle. I love that she made it with the penne.
Mm-hmm.
It's like it's kind of like a chicken pot pie soup there. You okay? Well, we are really happy. We haven't had food on the show in a while.
It's working out good.
And I like
Rena, I haven't had yours yet.
But, okay. Oh.
What?
Here. Oh, yeah. You got to try Rena's. It's really good. All right, well, we're so excited.
Mm.
So if you want all these recipes, just text the word recipes to 763-797-7215. What do you think, Bob?
I'm getting there.
Okay. And we will send all these recipes to you.
Very good.
Isn't that nice?
Well, it's
I can taste
beans,
a nutmeg, too. I like it.
Yes.
Dictolini
all right.
in
we'll
there.
We'll be right back.
Very good.
Yeah.